Welcome to this lecture. So in this week we have been discussing the construction of probability measures from distribution functions. This will allow us to complete the correspondence between probability measures on the real line or in some higher dimensional Euclidean space with the collection of or the class of distribution functions on R or a appropriate higher dimensional Euclidean space. So we had left out a part of the proof in the previous lecture. So let us go to the slides and see what status we left the proof. Okay, so we'll have to look at the proof and look at the status of the proof. So we have started this construction of probability measures, which we denoted by mu subscript f for a given distribution function f. So here we are working in dimension 1. So here distribution function is a function taking values between 0 and 1. It's a non-decreasing right continuous function with limits at infinity and minus infinity being 1 and 0 respectively. So for such functions, we want to construct this set function and we want to show that this is non-negative, countably additive and assigns the total mass 1 to the set real line. So alright, so let's recall the setup that we have done so far. So what we do is that we had described this set function by specifying its values on the field of finite disjoint unions of left open right closed intervals in the real line. So remember this field script C we had discussed in week 1 and that generates the Borel sigma field on R. So this fact we are going to use and apply cathodic extension theorem to get the relevant extension from the field to the generated sigma field, which is the Borel sigma field. Alright, but then what did we do? We first observed that since the function is non-decreasing and has limits at infinity and minus infinity being 1 and 0, we can define or extend the function at the points infinity and minus infinity by specifying their values as 1 and 0. So thereby we are getting this function f as a function on R bar. It's still a non-decreasing right continuous function and it still has the appropriate limits. Alright, so that is the thing. And then we also have the fact that f still takes values between 0 and 1. So you are treating it as a function on the extended real line. And for such a function, what we did, we looked at this set function. So and we specified the values for the sets coming in this field of finite disjoint union of left open right closed intervals. So what did we do? So in preparation for this set function to be a probability measure, we assigned the value 0 to the empty set, value 1 to the real line, and for left open right closed intervals, we specified the structure of finite additivity by specifying these values. So for an interval of the type open A to closed B, we looked at the increment of the function. So by that I mean f of B minus f of A. So this value, we assigned to this set. Okay, so this left open right closed interval. So this is the value that we specified. But then in preparation for it to be finitely additive, we set that finite disjoint union of such intervals should be specified the value as the sum of the individual values, which is nothing but the sum of all these increments. So this will allow us to finish the definition on the field of finite disjoint union of left open right closed intervals. But then we verified that this mu subscript f turned out to be a non-negative finitely additive set function on this field, and we wanted to verify a continuity property of this set function in order for us to claim that mu subscript f is countably additive on the field script C. Okay, so that is the trick that we are using. So instead of directly trying to prove countable additivity, we first show finite additivity and then verify appropriate continuity properties of this set function on the field to allow us to claim countable additivity. All right, but then you will see that this is also not a easy task. We have to go to certain technical arguments and prove the relevant continuity properties. A direct proof of countable additivity may be much more difficult. Okay, so let's go and see how we can show the relevant continuity property, which is continuity from above at the empty set. All right, so before we go forward, let's make a few comments. So the first thing is that we are going to use the fact that the extended real line is compact. So what did we do on the real line? We attached extra points, which are plus infinity and minus infinity. You can think of these as some kind of limit points. Okay, and once you add these limit points, this set, the set of extended real numbers, which is denoted by R bar, becomes compact. So the proof of this result is beyond the scope of this course, and we just assume it for our discussion. All right, so we are not going to prove this fact. Now, as we are going to see below, this compactness is going to help us prove the relevant continuity property. Okay, but then remember, the original set function that we are dealing with, that is so far defined on the field of finite disjoint union of left open right closed intervals in the real line. Okay, so you are still within the realm of the real line and you haven't gone to the extended real line. So therefore, to use this structure of the extended real line, what you need to do is to make some connection with the appropriate set function on R bar on the extended real line. So what we do, we are going to connect this mu f, which is defined on the field of finite disjoint unions of left open right closed intervals in R, with an appropriate set function defined on some collection of subsets of the extended real line. So this is what we do, and once you make the connection, only then you are able to use the compactness properties of the extended real line. So this is the procedure that we are going to use. All right, now recall that we already have a good candidate of this nice collection of subsets on the real line. So the candidate is that the finite disjoint union of left open right closed intervals on the extended real line, and remember, this again forms a field. Okay, so if you look at this collection of left open right closed intervals, take finite disjoint unions of those, then it will form a field on the extended real line. Of course, you have to remember the appropriate interpretations for open A to closed B, because here we are allowing the points plus infinity and minus infinity to be in these intervals. Okay, the extended real line contains the points plus infinity and minus infinity. So just to distinguish this field that we could talk about on the extended real line, we are going to denote it by C bar. So the field on extended real line, the R bar, is going to be denoted by C bar. So as you can expect, there is some kind of a connection between the field script C, which is on the real line, and with the field C bar on the extended real line R bar. Now remember, we are going to use these intervals open A to closed B, but this open A to closed B can appear as a subset of the real line, in which case you have to use the appropriate interpretation for B being infinity or A being minus infinity. Similarly, when you are talking about this interval on the extended real line, be careful about this notation. Then these points plus infinity or minus infinity may be inside your set. Okay, so now we are going to complete the proof that we left out in the previous lecture. So we are going to verify the relevant continuity property for the mu subscript f as left out in step 3. So we split this part into several further sub-steps. So we start with this observation that we can consider a set function on the field of finite disjoint union of left open right closed intervals on the extended real line, so on C bar. So we are defining this set function and we are denoting it by mu bar. As you can expect, there should be some connection with mu subscript f that we have defined. But let us see how we define this. So again, we are going to set it to be 0 for the empty set. We are going to set the value 1 for the extended real line. And for intervals of this type, we are going to use this increment structure that we have already set for the mu f. Okay. So similar structure we are just going to retain for this mu bar of f. So then what you can immediately observe that as argued for mu subscript f, you can use the same argument and show that mu bar that you have just mentioned is a non-negative set function. This will also become finitely additive. Okay, but then very important, this is still defined on the field C bar, which is a field on R bar, the extended real line. But now observe that these two set functions, mu bar and mu, so mu bar subscript f and mu subscript f, agree on left open right closed intervals. So before we state this proof of this result, let's first clarify what exactly we mean here by left open right closed intervals. So on the left hand side, you choose a and b within this range. So a and b could be plus infinity or minus infinity. But on the left hand side, you have to be careful that these sets should be interpreted in the sense of sets inside the extended real line and therefore may contain the infinity points. Alright, on the right hand side, again you look at the same notation, left open right closed intervals for such AB, but here we are going to treat these intervals as intervals within the real line and therefore they will not contain the points plus infinity or minus infinity. Even though the left end point A and the right end point B may be taken to be plus infinity or minus infinity, as per our notational justification that we have been following so far, as long as these sets are within the real line, we are not including the points infinity or minus infinity inside. Okay, so therefore on your left hand side, when you are applying mu bar, you will treat the set as a set inside the extended real line. Whereas on the right hand side, when you are looking at this interval, you should treat it as a set inside the real line. Alright, so that is the proper notational justification. But now, what is the proof for this fact? Look at the left hand side, that is defined as per our definition given above as the increment of the function values, that is simply f of b minus f of a. But that is the exact same value when you look at the right hand side. So again, the size of this set under mu f is exactly f of b minus f of a. Since both are defined through the increment of the function values, we are easily able to compare and see that these two functions attach the same size to such left open right closed intervals, but with the appropriate notational justification that the left open right closed interval AB has to be treated as a set inside the extended real line on the left hand side, and on the right hand side it has to be treated as a set inside the real line. But now let's start off with the argument. So we want to show what? We want to show that given any decreasing sequence of sets inside the field that is on the real line, okay, so this is the finite disjoint union of left open right closed intervals inside the real line. So for that field, we want to show that the set function that we have defined on this field, this we want to show to be countably additive, and we want to show it's continuous from above. To do that, we start off with a general sequence A subscript n inside this field which decrease and decrease to the empty set. So its full intersection, this countable intersection, is the empty set. Okay, so here we split the case into two possible subcases. Okay, so in the first subcase, what we are doing is that since this sequence of sets that we are considering are decreasing, then there might exist a suitable integer, large enough integer, such that after a certain stage all the sets are just empty sets. So this can happen, and in this case of course the intersection of all these sets is empty. But there may be a opposite case, that in the case of all such natural numbers n, your sets an, which is a finite disjoint union of left open right closed intervals, is not empty. Okay, so these are certain non-trivial sets, but they decrease and decrease to the empty set. So there are these two cases. So the first case, Roman one, is easy to handle. So observe that if you look at the size of these sets according to the set function that we have defined. So since ans are empty sets after this stage n naught, then it will get the value 0, okay, as per the definition that we have already considered. So therefore, if you consider the limit of these sizes, this will also be 0 and agree with the value associated to the empty set. But then the rest of the argument will going to focus on the case Roman 2, where these sets an, the sequence of sets an, is non-trivial. So they are non-trivial, meaning they are not empty sets, but they decrease and decrease to the empty set. Very good. So let's now make another observation. So here we are starting off with some interval, left open right closed interval, inside the real line. What we observe first is that this set is inside the field that we have considered, but then this set is also inside the extended real line. Alright, so just to be clear, when you fix this a and b, if a and b are real numbers, then there is no problem. So that's the type of sets we are considering here. Okay, but if b is equal to infinity, then you have to make the appropriate justification. Alright, but then what we are going to consider is this left endpoint a. Okay, and we use right continuity of the given distribution function capital F. What do? We choose a decreasing sequence of real numbers. So here we are not using extended real numbers. We are going to use a decreasing sequence of real numbers, call it an. We can construct such a sequence such that the limit is that number a, the left endpoint of that interval. We can choose such a sequence of real numbers, and by the right continuity of the distribution function, we can also claim that f at an, the function value at an, will go down to the function value at a. Okay, so this is simply using the right continuity of the distribution function. So now observe that the value associated to these sets, open an to b, so this is also a left open right closed interval, and you can think of it as inside the real line as well as the extended real line. So if you think of it as a set inside the extended real line, then what is the value associated to it by the mu bar of f? So that is nothing but this increment of the functions. Now take limits as n go to infinity. So you have to consider this limit now. But then here only limit that you need to consider about is f of an. But then by the right continuity, f of an converges to f of a. So therefore, this is nothing but the size of the set under the set function mu bar. Okay, so we are focusing on mu bar here. So we will see the reason why. So what we are saying is this, that given this epsilon positive, we can choose some a prime which is slightly larger than a. So this could be chosen as one of the ans that approximate the value a from above. Okay, so you can choose such a value a prime by approximating it from above, such that this set gets associated smaller mass. So that's very clear. So a prime is bigger than a, so the set open a prime to closed b is contained in open a to closed b. So even for finitely additive set functions like this, you can easily check that this inequality will hold. And what we are going to observe is that by this right continuity argument, we can actually approximate it from above side in this sense, that you can choose this value a prime so that you get a slightly smaller set inside the interval open a to b. So you are now choosing this interval open a prime to b, which is a slightly smaller interval contained inside, but its size is very close, in the sense that given this epsilon positive, the size of this plus epsilon will be an upper bound for the size of open A to closed B. So why is this again? So this is purely for the reason that this limit is this limit value. Okay, so this limit is exactly this size. Okay, for exactly this reason, this value plus epsilon for an appropriate choice of A prime, you can get this inequality. So moreover, observe another fact that the closure of this left open right closed interval with this approximating interval that you have just constructed is this closure of A prime to B, but that is contained inside open A to closed B. That is, by construction, A prime is always a real number. Alright, that is by construction. Alright, so this observation that we did says that given any interval open A to closed B, consider any such interval, then you can look at the size of this interval according to mu bar of F, and you can obtain a slightly smaller interval such that it's still a left open right closed interval, but it approximates the size of the given interval with a pre-assigned error bound. Okay, so given any epsilon positive, you can figure out such a interval which is contained inside the open A to closed B. All right, so now we go back to the step 2. So what was this? So we wanted to show the continuity from above for this sequence AN. All right, so that was the step, and we were assuming now that all these ANs are not the empty sets, but they decrease to the empty set. So the complete intersection, the countable intersection, is the empty set. So let's start that argument once more. So here, these left open right closed intervals or their finite disjoint unions can be considered as a sequence in C bar, which is a field on the extended real line. But since each AN is either a left open right closed interval or a finite disjoint union of such intervals, we can now construct a sequence BN again in inside the field such that BN is contained in the closure of BN. So that's fine, but BN closure should be contained in AN such that the sets BN that sizes approximates this in this format. Okay, so remember here ANs and BNs are sets inside the real line, so you can treat them as sets inside C bar or otherwise. So here mu bar or mu f both will assign the same values. All right, but then interestingly enough, by the construction that we mentioned in the previous step, even if ANs are one single left open right closed interval or a finite disjoint union of them, for each such interval you can approximate it from inside by a pre-assigned error bound, and by that you can construct these sets BN. So if ANs are finite disjoint unions of left open right closed intervals, for each interval you take that smaller interval contained inside, take their finite disjoint unions, then they will give you these sets BN for you with this as pre-assigned error bounds. Okay, so you can choose this epsilon accordingly beforehand, and you can set this error bound by yourself, so that's not a problem. So for each n BN, which is again a finite disjoint union of left open right closed intervals but purely contained inside the real line. Okay, so that's why there is no distinction here between mu f and mu bar. But then observe that the complete intersection, the countable intersections of ANs, are given to be the empty sets, and BN closures are contained inside ANs, so their countable intersection is also the empty sets. Now think of these BN closures as sets inside the extended real line. You can now say that the union of the complements, which we write is in this notation, R bar minus BN closure. So this is the complement of BN closure inside the extended real line. So here what is happening is that these complements, if you look at the union of that, that will be the extended real line. So this is simply just flipping this relation by doing complementation. So this intersection becomes a union of the complements. But then BN closures are closed sets, so R bar minus this BN closures, the complements, will be open sets. Okay, And what we are saying is that the union, the countable union of these open sets is covering the whole of the extended real line. But since extended real line is compact, so here we appeal to the compactness of the extended real line, you must find finitely many such open sets whose union will be exactly the extended real line. So simply stated, there exists a natural number n naught such that the union of first n naught of these sets will cover the extended real line. So you don't have to look at n from 1 to infinity, you don't have to look at all the sets, you can stop at a finite stage, you can figure out such a n naught such that this finite union will already cover the whole of extended real line. But then now again go back to the complemented version of this statement. So this union becomes an intersection. So then you immediately are able to claim that intersection of this finitely many Bn closures is the empty set. Okay, so this is simply complementing this relation on both sides. Very good. So now we have this fact that the finite intersection of this first few Bn closures is already giving you an empty set. Now if you use the upper bound that is mentioned in step 3D, so let's go back. So in step 3D, remember that mu f of an will be less or equal to this quantity. Okay, so if you use appropriate set theoretic argument, what we will be able to show is that mu f of an will be small. Okay, so that's all we are basically doing. So if you go about doing that argument, you will be able to show that for the set an naught, you will get this upper bound. Okay, so you have to do it appropriate set theoretic way by looking at all these inclusions between the sets. You have to do a bit of a argument, try to work this out, but from the statement that the finite intersection of all these Bn closures is the empty set, you can then try to show that mu bar associates the value smaller than epsilon to the set an naught. But then for the later sets, the sets come afterwards, these sets an are contained inside an naught because this is a decreasing sequence and therefore their sizes will be smaller. So therefore for this n naught onwards, all the sizes are smaller than epsilon. But what do we do? We had fixed that epsilon beforehand and then we have somehow figured out this value of n naught. So therefore what we are saying is that given any epsilon positive, we can figure out this n naught such that the size of the sets after that stage onwards is smaller than epsilon. And that is exactly the definition of the limit, saying that the limit of mu bar of f if the sets an will be 0. Okay, so the value assigned to the sets an by the set function mu bar, that limit will be 0. But then as long as you consider these sets within the real line, mu bar and mu agree. So this is something we had already observed, and therefore you can immediately claim that mu f of an is exactly equal to 0. Okay, so what did we do? We started with a decreasing sequence of sets an inside the field of finite disjoint union of left open right closed intervals in the real line. So for such sequence of sets, we have shown that that limit value for these sizes is 0. So therefore this will show you the continuity from above at the empty set. And hence it will now complete the proof of that claim in step 3. And the later steps we have already discussed in the previous lecture, that afterwards you claim countable additivity of the set function mu f and then appeal to the characteristic extension theorem to get the appropriate extension to the whole of real line with the Borel sigma field, that measurable space. Okay, so this completes the proof of that claim. But then note that with this construction, we have now constructed these probability measures corresponding to distribution functions. And just to formally write down the correspondence that we have mentioned multiple times, now everything is proved. So what we have now proved is the following correspondence, that on one hand, if you consider the probability measures on the real line with the Borel sigma field, and on another hand you consider this class of distribution functions. So by that I mean it's a function defined on the real line taking values between 0 and 1, it's a non-decreasing right continuous function limits at infinity and minus infinity being 1 and 0 respectively. So there is this nice correspondence between these two collection of sets or these two collections, and this is completing the connection between random variables, their corresponding laws and their corresponding distribution functions. So you have completed that identification. Now we are going to discuss the higher dimensional analogs in a later lecture in this week. Another comment before we stop is that if we use mu bar right from the beginning, so here what did we do in the previous lecture? We started with mu f, which is defined on this field of finite disjoint union of left open right closed intervals inside the real line. But if you start with the extended real line, consider the finite disjoint union of left open right closed intervals inside the extended real line, there you can start talking about mu bar itself right from the beginning, right from step one. If you use that, then follow the argument, what you will be able to show is that this mu bar, as already mentioned, is non-negative, is finite iterative. Then you verify the relevant continuity properties, claim the countable relativity of mu bar on the field of finite disjoint union of left open right closed intervals inside the extended real lines. Then you can appeal to the cathode extension theorem and get an extension to this measurable space R bar together with the Borel sigma field of R bar. Okay. So the same construction that we have discussed, but we have avoided most of the construction or most of the terms involving the extended real line. We had bypassed that, but if you had started doing that right from the step one, you could have constructed a probability measure on the extended real line together with the Borel sigma field. Okay. So this is an important observation that says that given a distribution function, first of all, you can consider it as a function defined on the extended real line by specifying the value 1 at infinity and 0 at minus infinity. So you get that function. Corresponding to that function, you can construct this probability measure, let's call it mu bar, on the extended real line. Okay, and that is also in correspondence with that function that we have just talked about on the extended real line. And what you can then observe is that something that we have used in this proof, that for certain type of sets, this mu bar and mu f agree. So this you could extend using the principle of good sets. There are certain restrictions that we have mentioned earlier, that if you restrict a Borel set inside the extended real line, so by that I mean take a Borel set in the extended real line, take it intersection with the real line, so that will now become a Borel set inside the real line. So that is the identification that we are when writing these sets on both sides. Okay, so mu bar and mu f will agree under that identification. So what will happen is that if you had actually done this construction of mu bar starting from step one, then you would have obtained a probability measure on the extended real line. But the thing is that this Borel sigma field on the real line, if you take sets from that and do the appropriate identification, you could restrict the probability measure from R bar to the real line. So that is another way of proving this, but we want to avoid talking about too much on the extended real line. That is why we stayed with the real line and mu f almost throughout the proof. Only to prove the relevant continuity properties, we had brought in this R bar and prove the relevant properties. Okay, so here we have appealed to the extended real line's compactness, and therefore we have managed to prove the relevant continuity properties. Okay, so in later lectures we are going to see extended versions of this result for higher dimensional Euclidean spaces. So we'll continue this discussion in the next lecture.